2 minutes!
Inertia bounce expressions, guys. Let's do this. First and foremost, just copy the expression in the link description below. It's going to get our party started here. I got a number 2. You can use any layer you want. And I'm going to press P for position. And then I'll click on a stopwatch, create a keyframe right here. Go back and then just drag my 2 off the frame like so. Create another keyframe here. I'll press the spacebar. And you see it's a basic animation. But now I'm going to alt-click on the stopwatch here and then go to this area here and copy and paste the expression. Click out of it. Look at this. It's automatic. All you got to do is copy and paste it. It's so easy. It's super cool. But we can do that for anything. So I'm going to click out of the stopwatch here and press S for scale. Go here. Click on the stopwatch. And then go back here and then make scale 0. Press the spacebar. It goes from 0 to 100 really quick. Now I'm going to alt-click here, copy and paste the same exact expression, click out of it, press the spacebar. Look at that. It's super cool. How about we do that with rotation? No problem. Press R for rotation. Go right here, stopwatch, go back, and let's rotate this bad boy. Alt-click, copy and paste, click out of it. Same thing. How cool is that? Now, 3 numbers to keep in mind here are the amplitude, the frequency, and the decay. You can change these numbers. The amplitude, the higher the number, the more intense the bounce. Frequency is the number of bounce per second. So the higher the number, obviously you can have really quick bounces versus you have a lower number, you have slower, more calm bounces. And decay is how quickly the animation ends. The higher the number, the quicker the animation ends. The lower the number, the more the animation takes a little bit of time. And you just learned inertia bounce expressions in 2 minutes or less. Boom! Oh!